one shout amen.
Amen.
On your way sitting down, say the glory revealed.
The glory revealed.
The Apostle Paul is writing, and in his writing, he is trying to explain something to us. Romans 8 is quite of a intense scripture that deals with us understanding what we are dealing with in a world that we are not really from. He explains to us, because of the turmoil that happens psychologically in our minds when we have to deal with this thing called suffering. Suffering. Having to be under great oppression, having to deal with situations that causes us grief, causes us turmoil. And he says, I reckon, I have calculated that although I'm suffering, although we are dealing with suffering in this present time, I feel like this is with Jamaica, but there is a glory. He says here, the suffering of this present time is not worthy to be compared with the glory which shall be revealed in us. In other words, he's saying there is something that God wants to reveal in us. And although suffering precedes the glory, we must not think the suffering is the end. Because don't equate what you're going through to what you're going to be revealed. To what's going to be revealed. Someone say revealed.
Revealed.
I'm working this out as I preach. The glory which shall be revealed. The word revealed means disclosed. So it means something is about to be unveiled. Stay with me, I'm going somewhere. If you were here yesterday, you'll know I'm going somewhere. Someone say, it's about to be revealed.
It's about to be revealed.
Now, I grew up in Pentecostal church. I call it classical church when I'm talking, when I say this, because my father was what I call strict holiness preacher. I'm talking about to the point you could wear no pants if you were a woman. All right? You couldn't do your hair. You know what I'm talking about. No jewelry, no makeup. Women would make sure they have their head covered when they come to church. Classical, I call it holiness Pentecostal church. That's where I grew up on. And one of the things that I remember when I was in church, I would always hear people in church say, glory! And I thought that was a part of tongues growing up when they would say, glory! And you would feel literally something when they said, glory. But I didn't quite understand what that word actually meant. And so I want to unpack it today if I can, because I want us to understand about the glory that shall be revealed in us. In order to understand the word glory, we have to look at what it is in the original. Our Bible is written from a Hebrew and Aramaic perspective. And if you know anything about my ministry, I always revert back to the original of the word. So the word glory, and some of you preachers would have heard this, and you would have heard this many times, is the word kabod. And we heard in the Old Testament that the glory of God would turn up, in another word, it's called Shekinah. I hear people say Shekinah glory. When you say Shekinah glory, you have